Hallelujah. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Hallelujah. Christ is risen. Hallelujah. Christ is risen. Welcome to our service this morning. Glad that you all join us as we gather this morning to celebrate the rising of our Lord from the dead. Really, the only announcement, just a reminder, as you come today, sometime during service, there should be a pew pad along the center aisle. We ask you to pass that down somewhere. You can know your neighbors and also give us a chance to know who's here with us this day as we begin our service. And so that with that, are you doing that again for me? Okay. It's my birthday, so they had to sing happy birthday at the beginning. So we'll let you do the same, okay? So now that that's over, get to the worship. Please rise as we begin as our opening hymn, The Day of Resurrection. We continue as we remember our baptism this morning. For in the waters of baptism, we have passed over from death to life with Jesus Christ, and we are a new creation. For this saving mystery and for this water, let us bless God, who was, who is, and who is to come. We thank you, God. You open the gates of righteousness, and we pass safely through. In Jesus Christ, you calm the troubled waters. You nourish us and enclose us in safety. You call us forth and send us out in lush and barren places. You are with us. You have become our salvation. To you, our beginning and our end, our shepherd and lamb, be honor, glory, praise, and thanksgiving, now and forever. Amen. The love of God poured in to our hearts, the saving grace of Jesus Christ, the abundant life of the Holy Spirit, be with you all. We continue with our hymn of praise.
Let us pray. O God, you gave your only Son to suffer death for the cross and for our redemption. And by his glorious resurrection, you delivered us from the power of death. Make us die every day to sin, that we may live with him forever in the joy of resurrection. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God. Now and forever. Amen.
Amen. You may be seated for our readings this morning.
The first reading for today is from Acts chapter 10. And Peter opened his mouth and said, "Truly I perceive that God shows no partiality. But in every nation, anyone who fears him and does what is right is acceptable to him. You know the word which he sent to Israel, preaching good news of peace by Jesus Christ. He is Lord of all. The word which he was proclaimed throughout all Judea, beginning from Galilee, after the baptism which John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power, how he went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. And we are witnesses to all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree, but God raised him on the third day and made him manifest, not to all the people, but to us who were chosen by God as witnesses, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. And he commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one ordained by God to be judge of the living and the dead. To him all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. The word of the Lord. We will read the psalm responsively. Give thanks to the Lord, for the Lord is good. God's mercy endures forever. Let Israel now declare God's mercy endures forever. The Lord is my strength and my song, and has become my salvation. Shouts of rejoicing and salvation echo in the tents of the righteous. The right hand of the Lord acts valiantly. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. The right hand of the Lord acts valiantly. I shall not die, but live, and declare the works of the Lord. The Lord indeed punished me sorely, but he did not hand me over to death. Open for me the gates of righteousness. I will enter them and give thanks to the Lord. This is the gate of the Lord. Here the righteous may enter. I give thanks to you, for you have answered me, and you have become my salvation. The stone that the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. The second reading is from the first book of Corinthians, chapter 15. If for this life only we have hoped in Christ, we are all of men most to be pitied. But in fact, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For as by a man came death, by a man has come also the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all die, so also in Christ shall all be made alive, but each in its own order. Christ the first fruits, then at his coming those who belong to Christ. Then comes the end when he delivers the kingdom to God the Father after destroying every rule and every authority and power. For he must reign until he has put all his enemies under his feet. The last enemy to be destroyed is death. The word of the Lord.
I invite you to rise as you're able for our gospel acclamation this morning. Our holy gospel for this morning comes from the gospel of Luke in the 24th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Now on the first day of the week, at early dawn, the women came to the tomb taking spices that they had prepared. They found the stone rolled away from the tomb, but when they went in, they did not find the body. While they were perplexed about this, suddenly two men in dazzling clothes stood beside them. The women, who were terrified, bowed their faces to the ground, but the men said to them, "Why do you look for the living among the dead? He is not here. He has risen. Remember what he told you while he was still with you in Galilee, that the Son of Man must be handed over to sinners to be crucified and on the third day rise again." Then They remembered his words. And returning from the tomb, they told this to the 11 and all the rest. Now this was Mary Magdalene, Joanna, mother of Mary, the mother of James and the other women who were with them, who told this to the apostles. But those words seemed to them to be an idle tale, and they did not believe them. But Peter got up and ran to the tomb, stooping and looking in. He saw the linen clothes by themselves, and he went home, amazed at what had happened. This is the gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Please be seated and invite the children to come forward for a message. Hi, good morning. Good morning. How are you all today? So, what is today?
Easter.
Easter. What's Easter about? Jesus rising from the dead. Yeah. Today we celebrate the fact that Jesus, our Savior, overcame death and was raised from the dead. But something else happened today that some of you had help with a few weeks ago. We took a word, and we kind of folded it up and we put it into a little box and held it off during the time of Lent. Do you remember what the word is? Were any of you here? Hallelujah! Right, exactly. And now, if you look over there, what do you see? See that? See the word the word on the pillar? What's that say? Hallelujah! Right, now we can say the word, right? For those last few weeks, we have not been able to say that word because we weren't ready to celebrate, but today, we get to celebrate, and we get to say the word, hallelujah. And that's why, do you have bells when you came in? Do you get bells, right? And what do you get to do when you hear the word hallelujah today? We get to ring the bells, right? So we're going to ring the bells as we say the word, and because we get to celebrate, because today is the day that our Savior was broke the bonds of death for not only himself, but for all of us. So let's pray. Gracious God, we give you thanks because you raised your Son from the dead so that we might celebrate, that we might proclaim, hallelujah, he has risen indeed. Guide us in these days and all we do, that we may continue to proclaim this word, that we may continue to say, hallelujah, for Christ has risen. We ask this and pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Thanks for coming up today. So let us pray. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. So we are told it was early dawn on that first day of the week following the Sabbath, that the women went out and came to the tomb. Early dawn. Early dawn meaning the women had probably gotten up well before light had come, ready to get to the tomb to do that which they had always and been accustomed to doing, to caring for someone who in their life who had died. But this time it would be different. Now, early dawn is an really interesting time of the day. If you're one of those early risers and you get to see dawn rising, the sun rising over the horizon, it's a great time of the morning. Watching the sun rise, you witness the beginning of a new day. Now, sometimes dawn, the beginning of a new day, is a welcome sight. Sometimes you rejoice in it. Sometimes you're just glad to get up and see the morning begin. When I think about the dawn, sometimes it's always reminded that when I was younger, my family and I, we would go camping. We did that a lot. We went tent camping. We went in one of the local parks. And my dad, who was always an early riser anyway, would get up and try and make his way through the tent and get out to rekindle the fire from the night before to begin making the coffee, to begin his day. And then my brothers and I would soon follow after that, getting up and hoping that maybe we'd get a little fishing in before the before breakfast came. Good mornings of watching the sunrise as you got ready to go fish from the lake or the creek or wherever it is that we were camping that week. Later in life, though, I know that there were some of those early dawn mornings that weren't quite as welcomed. Because you had to, well, I grew up, we worked on a farm, and so you always had to get up. You had to get up early, you know, get there at 6 a.m. so you could take care of the animals. They needed to be fed and watered and cared for. 6 a.m. came pretty early some mornings, particularly on those cold winter days when you just wanted to be snug, warm in the bed, not getting up. But even on those mornings, even on those cold mornings when you really didn't want to be anywhere else, watching the sunrise gave you hope, because you knew it brought warmth, it brought light, it brought a promise of a new day. It was the women making their way to the tomb that morning as the dawn of a new day began. That may not have been a welcome sight for them, because they knew what they expected to be for them in that morning's work. They knew what to expect because they had done this before. They had been there. They had gathered all the things they needed as they made their way out of their house, down the streets, out to where the body was, out to the tomb. They set out early that morning, going to take care of a friend who had died, who had now, as they thought, lay in the tombs of the dead. But this was different. For the death of their friend, the death of Jesus, was not like any other. They arrive and they find that the tomb is already open. They find that there is no body there. They find it empty. And when their friend is gone, they stand there and says they are perplexed, when suddenly that two angels show up among them, asking them, "Why are you looking for the living among the dead? For he is not here, for he has risen." And then they remind them of all that Jesus had told them while he was with them in Galilee. Now, at this point in the Gospel of Luke, there is no resurrection appearance. There is no encounter with the risen Lord. Oh, we only get the word that the tomb is empty and that he has been raised from the dead. We only get the remembrance of all the things that Jesus said about himself, how he would be betrayed and handed over, that he would be crucified and died, but he would rise on the third day. It was only after those angels spoke those words that the women remembered. And now they became the first witnesses. They became the witnesses on this dawn of a new day and a new time, and they hurried back to tell the apostles of all that they had heard. They quickly returned to tell them of what they had seen, how the tomb was empty. But yet, as they arrive, we are told that apostles, Peter and the others, dismissed them. They were just telling idle tales. They were telling fake news. They were telling stories that need not to be believed. But yet the women were speaking of what they remembered, of what they heard. That probably at least piqued Peter's interest a little bit, because then we are told that Peter got up. Peter ran back to the tomb to see for himself, and finding the tomb empty and the grave clothes lying there, it says he returned home amazed at what happened. But we don't know if he returned home amazed at what happened because he believed and he too remembered all what Jesus had said, or if he just returned home amazed that the tomb was empty and now there was more questions than answers. But in the Gospel of Luke, it doesn't take long for these encounters with the risen Lord to come. In fact, right after, our reading for today becomes one of my favorite stories in the Gospel of Luke. It's about a guy named Cleopas and his friend, who had also been in Jerusalem on that for the Passover. They'd been there for that time of the festival, and now on this first day of the week, they were headed home. They were headed home back down to Emmaus, and they were walking along and talking, it said, about all the things that had taken place, when it said Jesus comes and walks with them. Yet they were kept from knowing who Jesus was. And so Jesus asked him, what are you talking about as you walk along? And it says, they were amazed and said, why are you the only person in Jerusalem who did not know what took place? And as they walk along, they begin to witness to Jesus, telling him of all the things that they witnessed through that week, that time of the festival. How they had hoped that Jesus of Nazareth was the one that they had waited for. Yet the authorities had handed him over, and he was crucified and died and was buried in a tomb. But they said, but we had heard from the women that the tomb was empty and that Jesus was alive, but now we're headed home because we had hoped that he would be the one. Jesus takes the time as they walk along to remind them of all the things that he had talked to them about, all the things that the scriptures said about who the Messiah was to be. And they get close to home, they get to the edge of town, at the edge of Emmaus, and it says, they invite Jesus to stay with them because it is late. And there at the meal that they gather for, there in the breaking of the bread, it says, they recognize Jesus in the breaking of the bread, and he vanishes before their eyes. And then they are amazed and perplexed because did not we know that this was Jesus among us? And they get up and they do something that was totally unexpected. They make their way back to Jerusalem in the middle of the night on a very dangerous road to tell others, to give witness to what they had seen. And they find Peter and the apostles gathered together, and they come and they tell all that they had seen and how Jesus was made known to them in the breaking of the bread. Then as they were speaking, we are told Jesus shows up. Jesus shows up in the flesh. He shows them his hands and his feet. He shows them the scars of the crucifixion. He shows them that he is there, truly alive. A whole new day, a whole new world was dawning. And they would be the witnesses of this inbreaking of the kingdom of God that Jesus had been proclaiming to them since the very beginning. It is here on this day, this new day, that we too are continued to be called witnesses to what it is that we believe. Yet I know for many that I get comments sometimes like, I wish I was one of them. I wish I was one of those apostles who was in that room that day so that I too could see Jesus, so I could experience and know and believe. But we, like the women, we just know because we have been told. The words that Jesus had spoken, we remember all the things that we have been taught. But we also have seen Jesus. We have seen him in those holy moments in our lives when children are born and people are baptized, when we gather at the bedside of someone who is dying. Christ is there. It's in those thin moments of time when that veil between us and the hereafter seemed to get just a little bit thinner. It is there that we too experience Christ. It is there too that we see the risen Lord. It is there that we also come, and whenever we gather here around the table that our Lord gives us, it is in the breaking of the bread and the pouring of the wine that our Lord is revealed. It is here that we see his presence, that our eyes are opened. It is here on this new day, on this new dawning of a new time in our lives, that Christ is among us. It is here that we encounter the risen Lord, and then we are sent to proclaim that our Lord has risen. He has risen indeed. Alleluia. Amen. I invite you to stand as you are able as we sing our hymn of this day, that Easter day was joy and bright.
Easter day with joy was bright, the sun.
Living in trust and hope, we confess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified and died and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of life, and the life everlasting. Amen. Risen like the morning star, holy as a promise. Alleluia. Christ is Lord. Let us pray. We rejoice in the risen Christ, who came to set all people free. May your church be willing to love beyond limits, accept without conditions, and model the God we serve in all we say and do. Hear us, O God. We rejoice in the risen Christ, who rules over heaven and earth. We are thankful for skies and fields, rivers and seeds. Help us steward this world well. Help us, O God, your mercy is. We rejoice in the risen Christ, who knows every injustice. We pray for nations and governments, for compassionate hearts of the powerful. Make us all instruments of your peace. Hear us, O God. We rejoice in the risen Christ, who is here with us. Comfort the grieving, lonely, lost, and least, and all in need in mind, body, and spirit. Bless us as we do our part as healers, peacemakers, and hope givers. Hear us, O God. Holy God, bless our visitors among us today, those celebrating Easter with family and friends, and those who travel during this holiday season. We pray for victims of war and terror, and look for peace and an end to violence. Hear us, O God.
We offer these petitions and those that we carry in our hearts, trusting in your abundant and ever-present mercy. Amen. You may be seated as we come to our time of offering this morning.
God, you have blessed us with the fullness of creation. Now we gather at your feast, where you offer us the food that satisfies. Take and use what we have offered here. Come among us and feed us with the body and blood of Christ, in whose name we pray. Amen.
The Lord be with you, and also with you. Lift up your hearts, we lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give our thanks and praise. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places offer thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, whose suffering and death gave salvation to all. You gather your people around the tree of the cross, transforming death into life. And so with all the choirs of the angels, with the church on earth and the host of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, Lord God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy, mighty, and merciful Lord, heaven and earth are full of your glory. You sent in great love, you sent to us Jesus, your Son, who reached out to heal the sick and suffering, who preached good news to the poor, and who on the cross opened his arms to all. On the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread. He gave thanks, he broke it, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And after supper, he took a cup. He gave thanks and he gave it to all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." For remembering, therefore, his death, resurrection, and ascension, we await his coming in glory. Pour out upon us the spirit of your love, O Lord, and unite the wills of all who share this heavenly food, the body and blood of Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be all honor and glory now and forever. Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom as you teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated. Just a quick word of instruction as we come to the table this morning. All are welcome. It's Christ's table, and he invites you to come. And so we'll invite you to come down the side aisles. There'll be somebody holding a tray of cups there at the little cabinet there. You'll take a cup and join us around the altar. You can stand or kneel as you feel comfortable. If you would, and then you'll receive the bread and the wine, and then you'll return by the center aisle. If you like grape juice rather than the wine, there are a few cups of grape juice on the tray on top of the cabinet that you can bring with you to the altar this morning. So come, for all has been made ready this day.
Take us.
now may the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in eternal life. Amen. Let us pray. We give you thanks, O generous God, for in this bread and cup we have tasted the new heaven and new earth, where hunger and thirst are no more. Send us from the table as witnesses to the resurrection, that through our lives all may know life in Jesus' name. Amen. Oh, we have a spot. God, the author of life, Christ, the living cornerstone, the life-giving spirit of adoption, bless you now and forever. Amen. Okay. We sing our closing hymn, Jesus Christ is Risen Today.
Hallelujah, Christ is risen. Go in peace, tell what God has done.